Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. So, we're doing our Alan Wake series right now, and we did the first episode, and I think it was about the first half of chapter one. So, we're just gonna keep on trucking along here. So, let's get right into this.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Alright, so...
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Alright, we gotta get to the gas station. There goes the car. Oh boy. So much for having wheels. Not that that was gonna be useful for us anyway. Alright.
Hello?
Ooh. The light again.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Take a look at that, huh?
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
That's kind of spooky. All right. Keep on trucking. We got quite a hike ahead of us in the woods. The dark. Oh god.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
And he's gone. You know, he hit his head pretty hard. Maybe we're just seeing things, you know? Just some hallucinations. Maybe he's knocked out. Maybe this is all like a dream. Got another checkpoint. That's good.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Maybe. We'll see. But it probably wouldn't count on it. Also, at this point, we're like trespassing pretty bad, I believe.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Yeah, it's a cliff, so I'm not gonna go that way.
Hey!
Ooh.
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square!
Oh, boy. Big fights are taken with light.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Premium!
Please don't hurt me. Oh, okay.
You
He's got some crazy parkour skills. All right, the light's right there. We can do this.
Shit.
We can do this. We're right there.
The latest.
Oh, okay.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
There we go. Flashlight and revolver.
During your trying, it's the latest incontestably proven health
batteries.
I wasn't about to open the door as long as I was liable to catch an axe with my forehead.
I've got nowhere out of the phone.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. How may I?
Hello?
Oh no.
This is bad.
Yeah, it is. Oh god, we gotta go. Let's get to the gas station.
There were more of them.
Ah.
My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
I'm so lost. Ooh, okay. Not that way, I guess. Now we can go that way, I think. Right?
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
Ow. Oh, man. Got another checkpoint. Oh, well. My God.
What the hell was that?
Great question.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
All right, you can see the gas station. Figure out a way to get over there. Oh, there's logs right here. Another manuscript page. Barry's arrival.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Yo, that's crazy. Alright, so that didn't really get us anywhere.
Thank you.
I can hear him, but I can't see him, and
Stucky
I hate
was
it.
Still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Ow. Oh my god, they don't stop coming. How do I get past this? Not like that. Oh, I gotta climb these, okay. Wait a minute. They just have a lot of lumber yards in this town because it'd be the second one.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Another box.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site. This forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
All right, there we go. Now it's all coming together. All right, so 9 batteries, that's not too bad. Another checkpoint. Some shotgun ammo.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. Do listeners know I'm a night owl?
Yeah, something like that.
On nights like this, I wish I wasn't cooped up in this
room. Another page?
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
All right, let's keep on trucking. Oh man, it's getting close.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no
contest. Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Yo, this is intense. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm pretty shook right now. Another box. Get our stuff. Energizer. Funny that like there's like it's branded. Pages up there. Okay.
Cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help, but I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
There's a shotgun. Good deal. There's more ammo for that. All right, let's go. Okay.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive.
All right, so we somehow survived that, despite, you know, me being me.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Colored clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night, and just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away.
All right, everybody, thank you for checking the video out. This one is a little on the short side, but I had the timing of the chapter off a little bit, I guess. But so if you made it through this, thank you very much. I greatly appreciate that, and I will see you guys next time.